Hello everyone, welcome to the HSPF training by DSI. This is the course HSPF 300 in which we will learn how to create a UCI file from scratch. And this is the video HSPF 310 in which we will learn to create a new project in BASINS. So for that we will launch BASINS from the start menu. Okay, so here is the BASINS welcome window. It gives me a couple of options. We'll check build new project. When we click on build new project, BASINS shows a map of HUC-8 watersheds in contiguous United States. So what we can do is we can select one of the HUC-8 watershed and BASINS will create a project around that watershed. And then we can download the data for that watershed. So for this project, I'm selecting the Snake River watershed. It's in eastern Minnesota, and I have worked on this watershed before, but we'll just use publicly available data for this course. So then I click on build. So it's going to ask me a couple of options, and what it does is it made a new folder, an empty folder, and gave a name to this project. Let's call it snake_310 and click save. So now BASINS asks the UTM zone for this project. So this is zone 15, I already know that, but you should always check it before going further. You should never accept the default options here, because if you have worked on a different project just before this project, it might be set to a different zone. So it's always a good idea to check the zone and then click on OK. So once I click on OK, what BASINS does is that it goes online, finds certain files, and some of the files are actually saved locally also. And then it does projects them, reprojects as needed, and then makes an empty project. So this one is a snake310.mwprj. It's not necessarily empty, but it's just very basic information. So we have the HUC-8 watershed boundary, version 1 reach file, state boundaries, and some state soil information that is very generic. Okay, so to make an HSPF model, we need some additional data. So what we will do is we'll go to file, download data. So the region to download is already selected as this HUC-8 number. What we will need is that in this case, we'll need DEM grid. National hydrography data, we have a newer version data available, so we'll click on all. Elevation grids, catchments, and hydrography. Discharge shows the locations at which the discharge data is available. 2016 NLCD data. We also want to see the NLDAS grid so that we can get the meteorological data for NLDAS. And that's it. Once I click download, what BASINS will do is it will start downloading the data from several websites and clip them and reproject them as needed for the project that we are working on. So what we'll do is we'll pause, we'll come back as it may take a few minutes, and then we'll continue from there. Okay, so after a couple of minutes of download, BASINS shows a summary of all the data that it has downloaded, and let's click on OK. So my recommendation is that when you are repeating this exercise on your own, to look at all of this data that has been downloaded, look at the attribute tables of this data that has been downloaded to see where it came from, how it came from, what are the properties of each one of them. So what we'll do in our next step is that we'll select the NL-DAS grid, and I'm unchecking all of the others, and we'll select the NL-DAS grids for which we need the meteorological data. So I'm selecting all the NL-DAS grids that are in this Hucket. So then I go File, Download Data. And since BASINS knows that I selected the NL-DAS grids, it's saying this box is checked, and it's giving me an option of changing the data time zone. So this is 6 hours difference from the, I think it's 6 hours difference from the UTC zone. So then I'll click on download, and then BASINS asks where to save it and what name to save it as WDM file. So it's in the same folder where it is making the project, it is saving it as a new WDM file. So once I click on OK, BASINS goes and start downloading all the data. And I've already downloaded the data, so I will skip this step for now, actually. So looks like whether I click on OK or whether I click cross, it still goes and download the data. So that's interesting. Anyway, so what BASINS will do, it will go in the background and download all the data and save it in WDM file that we already saw this in a previous video. Once all of that data is downloaded, then we can use one of those data to make an HSPF project. Now, when you are doing this project on your own or you are making an HSPF model, you will have data from multiple other sources also. So if they are simple GIS files, you can bring that data into this project. Or if you are comfortable using some other GIS software, you can take these shape files, and you can, after the data is downloaded, you can open these shapefiles in another software, and then you can do the processing as needed. So this completes the video, HSPF 310. In next video, we'll use some of the data that has been downloaded to make a simple HSPF model. Thank you.